I want to talk about this story. It's a horrible story. Very sad. And, you know, we talked at the beginning of the show about the news out of Florida where marriage equality will now be the law of Florida as of, I don't know, almost by the time we end this program today. The stay has been lifted, and it represents, I'm not sure, the 36th state now in the country where marriage equality is law of the land. 70% of Americans now live in a state where marriage equality is the standard. The implications of this are, I mean, I think it's fairly obvious from the perspective of people who want to get married. And it may also be somewhat obvious from the perspective of people who wanted to, who want to be considered just a citizen, essentially, with the same rights as the person standing to their left or their right. What it has done, I think, also, and perhaps on some level, most importantly, I don't know. I don't know how you gradate these things, is to send a message to younger people that you are not an illegitimate person. You are not a freak if you are gay. And, I mean, it seems like such an obvious thing to say now, but, you know, the reality is that when I was a kid, and certainly before then, there was no indication from society whatsoever of anything other than you're some type of freak if you're gay.
I think even when Matt and I were kids, there was, I mean, I don't think it was as bad as that, but there was a much higher tolerance of like calling kid a fag or whatever. I mean, it's mind blowing.
But at least, I mean, you know, I'm not sure when you guys went to high school, but even like things like Will and Grace, you know, that you had, or the Ellen, right? Coming out. At least there was some sense of like, yeah, look, here's someone who can be celebrated. And they're gay. And so there was at least some indication of like, you're not going to have to live your life denying who you are. You can actually come out and you will not be, or there are some people who have escaped punishment, let's say, for that. I mean, I don't know how else to put it. And I think the relevance of that for a young person is huge. And I think in 10 years, I think all of that is going to be gone. I mean, I really do think, yes, there's going to be some pockets and they're going to be in religious fundamental pockets, but the ability to escape those pockets is going to be obvious even to, I think, like, you know, tween age kids. Sadly, we're nowhere close to that in terms of transgender kids. I mean, I think there's definitely some, we're at early stages of it. And I think what's happening with marriage equality is going to help. But the story of Lila Alcorn, who was a transgender teenager from Ohio. And this happened, I guess, just a week ago yesterday. She was born a boy. She, I guess at a age four, according to her, realized that she was a woman or a girl, I guess, or had feelings that she was a girl trapped in a boy's body. And she committed suicide a week ago yesterday. by basically, as far as I can tell, walking on the interstate and throwing yourself in front of a truck. And she had posted a suicide note to her Tumblr account. I guess she had future published it and left it in her queue to publish automatically. And the idea was that in the event that she decided not to kill herself, she would take it out of its queue. I'm going to read just a little bit from it. It really is incredibly heartbreaking. And let me just read a little bit. If you're reading this, it means I've committed suicide and obviously failed to delete this post from my queue. Please don't be sad. It's for the better. The life I would have lived isn't worth living in because I'm transgender. She goes on to talk about how she's felt this way ever since she was 4. She was 17 when she killed herself. She writes, when I was 14, I learned what transgender meant and cried of happiness. After 10 years of confusion, I finally understood who I was. I immediately told my mom, and she reacted extremely negatively, telling me that it was a phase, that I would never truly be a girl, that God doesn't make mistakes, that I am wrong. If you're reading this, parents, please don't tell this to your kids. Even if you are Christian or against transgender people, don't ever say that to someone, especially your kid. That won't do anything but make them hate themselves. That's exactly what it did to me. When I was 16, I realized that my parents would never come around and that I would have to wait until I was 18 to start any sort of transitioning treatment, which absolutely broke my heart. The longer you wait, the harder it is to transition. I felt hopeless, that I was just going to look like a man in drag for the rest of my life. On my 16th birthday, when I didn't receive consent from my parents to start transitioning, I cried myself to sleep. I formed a sort of FU attitude towards my parents and came out as gay at school, thinking that if I eased into coming out as trans, it would be less of a shock. Although my reaction from my friends was positive, my parents were pissed. They felt like I was attacking their image, that I was an embarrassment to them. They wanted me to be their perfect little straight Christian boy, and that's obviously not what I wanted. So they took me out of public school, took away my laptop and phone, forbid me from getting any sort of social media, completely isolating me from my friends. This was probably the part of my life when I was the most depressed, and I'm surprised I didn't kill myself. I was completely alone for 5 months. No friends, no support, no love. Just my parents' disappointment and the cruelty of loneliness. Apparently, they ultimately let him, or her, I should say, get back in contact with her friends. But at that point, apparently, it seemed like there was a rift with the friends. She was, I think, clearly depressed. After a summer of having almost no friends, plus the weight of having to think about college, save money for moving out, keep my grades up, and go to church each week, I feel like shit because everyone there is against everything I live for. I've decided I've had enough. I'm never going to transition successfully, even when I move out. I'm never going to be happy with the way I look or sound. I'm never going to have enough friends to satisfy me. She goes on like this and ends it by saying, my death needs to be counted in the number of transgender people who commit suicide this year. I want someone to look at that number and say, that's effed up, and fix it. Fix society, please. Goodbye, Leela Alcorn. Her mom, when interviewed on CNN, still refused to recognize that she self-identified as a girl. She said, we don't support transgender identity religiously. Her mother continued, we told him that we loved him unconditionally. Supposedly they put him through, or her through, some type of Christian therapy. But there's calls essentially to provide LGBT kids with more mechanisms to actually get out from under and, you know, maybe go to a court at age 16 to see if they can get some type of court-granted consent to begin at least some transitioning. The heartbreaking thing about this is you know, for a 16-year-old kid, months, years even seem like an eternity. And
you know, as a parent though, like even if you're religious and you don't believe that transgender is a thing or whatever, and you're that close-minded and ridiculous, but like just as a parent, wouldn't you just, you know, if you think they're just a phase they're gonna grow out of, why not just go along? Like, why make your kid feel that way? Why make your kid feel like shit? Like, it's just amazing to me, the heartlessness of this whole story. And on top of it, it gets even more depressing because, I mean, it's clear that Lila wanted to put this Tumblr post up to help other kids, you know, make people realize don't treat transgender right. teens like this. And her whole Tumblr page has been removed now. The parents requested the entire Tumblr be taken down. So the suicide note that wow. she put up and all the Tumblr posts she ever put up are just gone now.
Well, I would imagine at least, at the very least, people have saved, you know.
I mean, I'm sure the note was right. saved, but I'm sure, you know, if you look through her history, I'm sure there were things she was saying that right. in retrospect, you know, could have helped someone.
Yeah, it's pretty stunning. It's pretty stunning. And it's, you know, it is really the saddest part about this on some level is how many kids are going to kill themselves until we get to where we're inevitably going to get to, which is an acceptance of transgender people. And we're seeing it, you know, there was over the past even 3 or 4 months, there's been a couple of legal cases that have been very, you know, positive. The military has, decided that they were going to, I guess the dynamic, if I remember correctly, was that following your service, they were going to recognize people changing their name and gender and continue to offer benefits. I think we saw in New Jersey a court case that allows for more legal status for transgender people. I mean, It's just horrible to contemplate how many kids are going to commit suicide between now and whenever society gets, and it's going to happen, and it may be 5 years, maybe 10 years, when that kid is not going to feel so isolated and is going to have, if they have parents who are that bat crap crazy fundamentalist, that person's going to be able to, you know, whatever it is, go and have access to people who can, you know, sort of make them understand or at least help them hang on till adulthood. And this kid was aware of the It Gets Better campaign. And I think that's what's even more heartbreaking is that, you know, it's just very hard for teenagers to have a... to realize that 3 or 4 years can make all the difference in the world. And also, I mean, I think she was probably depressed.
But like for transgender teens, can you imagine, you know, you identify as part of a group, you know, LGBT, and you see all these milestones happening with
right.
other people who are in this group, lesbians, gays, and you see that, you know, it's not changing that much quite yet for transgender right. people. So, I mean, that's got to hurt. It really right. does, you know?
Right. That's a very good point.